Bill Elliott has had problems under caution. Did he get hit? Watch, the field's under yellow, all caught up behind the pace car, and Elliott's car takes a sharp right turn, bit of smoke there, and pounds the wall.
Somebody must have run into the back of him, because, I mean, the car just took an abrupt left-hand turn.
Look at everybody scrambling that was
behind right-hand
him.
Turn, I'm sorry.
This is a very opportune time, and there you see it. Every one of our competitors on pit road here at lap 26.
Tony Stewart said his car started to get tight right near the end of that run. They're going to fix it with an air pressure change. Jeff Gooch Patterson with the gas can. Scott Radel says they're full. To Dick Bergeron.
Joe Nemechek is pitting, but he hasn't got a full-time pit crew, so he borrowed one from Scott Speed. These are all somebody else's guys over the wall. Steve.
Martin Truex Jr. said he was getting loose. He is away. Scott Riggs in the 36 with a makeshift pit crew from Germain Motorsports in the Truck Series. They had a clean pit stop. Jeff Gordon in the 24 saying, I'm having a hard time keeping this race car on the bottom of the racetrack.
Best Riggs. We can tell, looks like everybody changed four tires, which this was a great opportune time. We're almost halfway through this race.
We'll have to double check the race off pit road as Bill Elliott, look at the damage to the right front of his Wood Brothers Ford, is pushed back to the pit area. Dick, what happened?
Well, Bill Elliott's transmission locked up, Mike, and when it did, it absolutely locked the back wheels, and that spun him out.
Wow.
Wow.
I guess what he was doing, he's probably downshifting because we were under caution, and when he downshifted and maybe let the clutch out, the thing locked up and just spun him into the outside wall.
Now, Elliott will be in the Daytona 500. Now, a member of the number 27 crew borrowed from Regan Smith's 78 crew run into on the pit stop there. A car accelerating out slid sideways and caught him. We'll get an update when we can.
Now, I think there were a lot of issues.
Now, on pit road, Kyle Rowland is the crew member that was hit by Kirk Shelmerdine. He was servicing Shelmerdine's car and got hit on the pit stop. He was awake and talking to the caregivers and was assisted into the ambulance.
He has to use that championship provisional. Three cars that started at the rear of the field, now they're all locked into the show, but Jamie McMurray, Michael Waltrip, and Casey Mears in the 26, the 55, and the 07, all those cars, through virtue of the run they made before that pit stop and the pit stop, they've all made their way to the top 12.
You saw Kirk Shelmerdine making a second stop there, and we saw uniforms from three different pit crews servicing their cars as some of these single-car, part-time teams put together a group to get things done and try to get in the Daytona 500.
Even saw the Jackman from Jeff Burton, number 31 team there. Of course, Jeff will be in the next dual race coming up.
And Mike, looking at the team's overhead pit camera video, Kyle Rowland, when he jumped off the wall, you can see he was hit with the right front corner of the race car. Now, team officials told me he injured his shoulder yesterday, and this might have just made that injury, taking it to a whole nother step. Team officials did say he was talking and alert on the stretcher. We'll get more information as we have it from the Inside Care Center.
Now, from the uniform, we are guessing that Kyle Rowland was borrowed from Jeremy Mayfield's team. Jeremy's going to try to qualify for the 500 in race number two and is going to have to replace Kyle going over the wall, if that's the case.
And he just timed it wrong. I mean, he's the jack man. He's got to be the first guy over there, and he just got out there a little late, actually. He should have been out there a little sooner. And he didn't really know what to do.
Yeah, the rule is you can't go across into the car is one pit away. And like Darrell said, he just didn't time it. But one of the greatest things that NASCAR has done over the last few years is mandatory helmets on every pit crew member that goes across the wall.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, they'll penalize you a lap if you have a crew member over the wall.
Happened in the ARCA race to Joey Logano.
It did.
Dick Bergeron.
Bill Elliott had a fast car, and he was driving it beautifully, but that transmission locked up. What would cause that to happen, Bill?
If I knew, I'd fix it. I mean, guys, I don't know. I mean, it's part of, you know, you got parts and pieces and all this stuff's mechanical, and anything can happen. I mean, that's one flip side about what you need to do on Sunday, run as well as you can where you don't have to worry about these one fixes, because anything can happen. I mean, I was under caution, went to second gear, and it locked the transmission up, and that was it, you know, and I don't know what we're, you know, what went wrong, what happened, or whatever, but it's just a part of the business.
We look forward to seeing you on Sunday with better results. Thank you.
Sure.
Bill Elliott Sunday will start his 27th Daytona 500.